Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is your host for the day, Damini Gandhi, Marketing Manager at STANLEY Black & Decker Industrial Business. I take the honor of welcoming you all to our webinar, Seal It with the Avseal Advantage. First and foremost, I would like to thank you all for taking the time to be with us today. At STANLEY, we understand that sealing fasteners are a critical component for manufacturers to maintain a liquid-tight seal in mechanical systems. In this very context, we are all geared to share the results of research and testing conducted by our engineers that explains the damaging impact of incorrect sealing solutions. Now, we are equally elated to also present to you the solutions developed by our team that will have a positive impact on your business. Before we get started, please allow me to quickly walk you through some of our housekeeping announcements. To begin with, please share a word about us and the webinar and your experience using the hashtag #NothingElseSealsBetter. We look forward to hear from you on LinkedIn and other social channels of your preference. Next, we'll also have a live Q&A segment scheduled toward the end of the webinar. So please send in your questions using the Q&A widget at the bottom of your screen. And our experts will answer these questions during the Q&A segment. Lastly, please note that this webinar is being recorded as well. So a copy of the video will be made available to you via email. And in that same email, we will also share some downloadable resources and contact details for each region. So please keep an eye out for further communication. With that, ladies and gentlemen, I would like to introduce you to our first speaker, Thorsten Newell. Thorsten is the product line manager for Blind EU, and he's based out of Wetzlar, Germany. He is a product development and engineering professional with close to 20 years of experience in the fastening industry. A graduate in business and industrial engineering from Germany, his areas of expertise in the automotive and industrial domain varies from sealing fasteners, blind fasteners, studs, lock bolts, speed fasteners, blind rivets, sealing plugs, and many other equipments. At STANLEY, Thorsten has held several senior positions in project application engineering, sales, and product management. Now, as of his current role, he is responsible for driving customer projects and new product introduction initiatives based on the customer needs. And being an integral part of the team for several years, he becomes a very critical link between the customers, sales, and R&D in the organization. Without any further ado, please give it up for Thorsten. Over to you, Thorsten.
Yeah, hello everybody. My name is Thorsten and I'm talking from our EU automotive headquarters in Germany. Today, let's talk about sealing of holes, blind holes and supporting channels in die-cast applications like e-motors, gearboxes, actuators, valves, etc. Do you recognize the picture in the background? These are accidents, yes. Accidents and risk for life and safety can really happen as a worst case scenario due to sealing failures. So have you ever thought about the real cost of malfunction of a sealed hole or supporting channel in an e-motor, engine, gearbox, e-machine actuator or similar? Next slide, please. Yeah, what is the consequence of a failed sealing? Think about a typical application. For example, we talk about a gearbox, e-machine, highly engineered, very complex, long development cycles and highest requirements. Typically, the housings are made from die-cast material, aluminum or cast iron. After the die-casting process, the housings are prepared by machining. Holes and channels are drilled, and some of them, the supporting channels, are immediately closed again. Later, in serious operation, various liquids like water, oil, and cooling fluid run through many channels inside the housing, sometimes without pressure, but mostly with pressure. The pressure is needed for reaction time and activation of functions. If there is a little leakage, there is a drop of pressure, which could lead to a loss of function and ultimately to a total failure of the entire product. The consequences are warranty claims. If the gearbox fails and ultimately the vehicle can no longer run, the vehicle must be repaired under guarantee or warranty. Means a lot of cost for every single vehicle. Imagine from towing or transport cost, replacement vehicle for the downtime, replacement of the gearbox, working hours, and if necessary, compensation payment. The damage can add up to several thousand dollars per vehicle. Damage in reputation. In addition to warranty claims and repair costs, every single customer complaint leads to a loss of reputation. We spoke of the worst case scenarios, such as accidents, but every single failure leads to a dissatisfied customer. Imagine if there are reports in public that the vehicles from manufacturer XY are losing oil on a large scale. What damage would that be for the environment? This loss of reputation and trust extends from the end user through the OEM, through the entire supply chain. Recalls and repair costs. We just talked about warranty claims and reputational damage. In such cases, an OEM is quickly forced to make a change in the current vehicle generation and, in the worst case, even recall all vehicles previously produced. And then a repair is often impossible, so that the entire gearbox has to be replaced. A worldwide recall campaign costs several million dollars and leaves a lasting loss of trust. Next slide, please. We all now understand that sealing failures can, in worst case scenarios, can cost life. Having said that, we would now like to draw your attention to impact sealing failures can have on your business. I'm sure all our audience members are eager on finding out what will happen to my business when there's a sealing failure. Allow me to take you through how sealing failures can negatively impact your business. To begin with, let's talk about the performance ratio. While sealing plugs account for only 1 to 2% of the bill of material, if the sealing plug fails, not only are you dealing with a poor cost to performance ratio, you also to face the consequences like repairs, accidents, and recalls. Speaking of numbers, let's talk about assembly costs. Installation costs for alternative sealing methods can be high. Hole preparation methods such as reaming and thread cutting can be time consuming. Damage to customer components. Quality problems in sealing lead to failures in service. Plain hold eases the cleaning of application prior to plugging versus threads. No risk of cross-threading or over-torquing. Quality issues, hold preparation, consistency, debris in application, operator errors, vibration loosening, temper resistant, possibility of cross-threading or torque control issues. High cycle time, time spent on application hold preparation, lack of consistent repeatable setting, reliant on skilled operators. Consequences, we have heard already about the consequences, high cost of product failure, warranty claims, recalls, damaged reputation. With that, I want to hand over to Dominique. Thank you.
Thank you, Thorsten, for a very insightful and in-depth presentation. Now, all the attendees, please remember that we will be answering the questions you may have towards the end of the webinar. So please send in your questions using the Q&A widget on your screen. Now, before I invite our next speaker, I would like to give you a quick overview of STANLEY Engineered Fastening as to who we are. A division of STANLEY Black & Decker, STANLEY Engineered Fastening is the global leader in precision fastening and assembly solutions. We are a company that has been revolutionizing fastening and assembly technologies for almost 100 years. We are proud of our rich history and we use our past successes to inspire our future innovation. Being at the forefront of the industry from a technology standpoint, we ensure that our customers are truly benefiting from the world's most advanced fastening and assembly solutions. Our strategic family of brands are Avdel, Integra, Nelson, Optia, Pop, Stanley Assembly Technologies, and Tucker. As we speak, you can see the images of some of our products and their applications on your screen. We are headquartered in the United States of America with over 60,000 employees in over 60 countries, operating nearly 50 manufacturing facilities across America and more than 100 across globe. This was a quick overview of who we are. With that, please allow me to introduce our next speaker, John Brewer. John is a principal engineer and global lead for Avdel IP Europe. With 40 years of experience in the fastener business, he's extremely passionate about problem solving and creating innovative engineering solutions. He's a mechanical engineer graduate from Loughborough University and a named inventor of numerous patented designs for blind brake stem rivets, sealing plugs, speed fastening system, and installation tooling. As of his current role, John is a principal engineer at Letchworth Garden City R&D Center in England. Ladies and gentlemen, let's now hear from John.
Thank you, Damini. Could I have the next slide, please? Okay, in this section, I want to introduce the Avseal system. And I say system, as STANLEY Engineered Fastening does not just provide mechanical sealing plugs. We also offer our own designed installation equipment to suit these plugs, ranging from handheld tools to fully automated placing equipment. And on top of this, we offer customers around the world our technical advice and guidance to help with selection and specification. So these three factors combined make for the complete Avseal system. The following short video will give you an insight into how Avseal plugs work. Okay. Avseal plugs were first designed by Avdel back in 1980, and the designs and manufacturing methods have been developed and refined continuously ever since. The basic concept appears and is quite simple. A soft aluminium sleeve is combined with a steel stem, and it is placed rather like a blind rivet, where the placing tool pulls on the stem and it breaks off at a predetermined load. The difference from blind rivets is that the pulling force is converted into radial expansion of a soft metal sleeve, and that generates the seal against the hole. In more detail, what happens is that the sleeve is axially compressed between the stem head and the tool nose tip. This compression causes the sleeve to swell outwards until it contacts the wall of the hole. High radial pressure is developed, which holds the plug securely in place by friction. In the photo on the left, you will see that much of the outer surface of the sleeve is in contact with the hole. You will also see a raised annular ring under the stem head, and that's shown as feature 4. This ring gets embedded in the end face of the sleeve, and it means that fluid cannot pass between the stem and the sleeve bore. During placing, there is also very high pressure of sleeve material that's acting radially inwards onto the shank of the stem. Here you will see a shallow groove, and that's feature 5. This provides a positive lock between the stem and the sleeve. Now, the lock is important for two reasons. Firstly, it resists the recoil action that occurs when the stem breaker groove snaps, and it stops the stem head from rebounding out of the sleeve. The second advantage is that it maintains a robust plug assembly. And that means that if the stem is knocked accidentally from the outside, it doesn't move. Okay, next slide, please. The hole for Avseal plug is simply drilled. There's no need for reaming or tapping operations. The roughness limits you see on the screen would normally be achieved by conventional drilling. There are just two key requirements. First, the hole must be free of any axial scratch marks, as these could provide a leak path around the installed plug. So it's important, for example, to keep the drill spinning when it is withdrawn from the hole, and this is to avoid these scratch marks and this problem. The second requirement is to clean the hole after drilling. This makes sure it has no debris, such as metal swarf or dirt, and it ensures that the surface is free of grease and oil. Next slide, please. So moving on to the Avseal plug ranges, we have three families. There's the low pressure and high pressure families. The difference here being that the low pressure versions have slimmer stems and lower brake loads. Then there is the Avseal XT, ultra high pressure family for hydraulic power and control applications. Together, these three families allow fluid sealing of air, water-based coolants, lubricating oils, and hydraulic fluids in an enormous range of applications, in hole sizes from 4 millimeters right up to 22 millimeters. A further note is that the high pressure Avseal in particular can accommodate a very wide hole tolerance. For example, a 10 millimeter plug can be used in holes that vary in size by up to 1 millimeter. So in summary, Avseal is very robust to hole manufacturing tolerances. Next slide, please. When we're talking about performance of mechanical sealing plugs, one key measure is blowout pressure. And this can be likened to a champagne cork coming out of a bottle. In the test, increasing fluid pressure combined with the cross-sectional area of the hole eventually overcomes the frictional force provided by the sleeve in the hole, and the hole plug is forcibly ejected. We test our plugs using oil pressure and we record the peak value. So in this chart, you see oil pressure of three different families is shown. The typical pressures are 300 bar for the low pressure plugs, 900 bar for the high pressure plugs, and over 1600 bar for the Avseal XT. And that's as shown by these blue bars. Now, I say typical, however, as three factors have a bearing on the actual peak blowout pressure performance. These are the surface roughness of the hole, the hole diameter, and the metal in which the test is conducted. And that could be in aluminium, cast iron, or stainless steel, for example. And each of these will influence the eventual blowout value. It's for this reason that we only provide indicative pressures, because every single customer application is unique. Of course, in service, we don't want to risk the plug being ejected from the application. So a safety factor of 3 or 4 is typically applied. So if we can click the button again, there. So what this means is that the normal maximum working pressure for the plugs will be far lower, as shown by these green bars. For example, for the low pressure Avseal, it could be 100 bar. For high pressure Avseal, 300 bar. And for Avseal XT, the working pressure would be up to 500 bar. Next slide, please. Now, we have seen that there is a wide range of standard Avseal plugs available. However, we can also offer customized designs to meet certain particular requirements of customers. For example, a shortened sleeve, which is often combined with a reduced stem head thickness, can be provided for applications where the hole to be sealed is very shallow. We also have seen very complex castings that require plugging in positions that are just too difficult to access with a normal placing tool. To overcome this problem, we can provide a longer stem on the plug, which allows the use of specially made extended nose tips to gain access deep inside the casting. Other options include special surface finishes on the stem, and these would be for increased corrosion resistance, and customer-specific packaging or labeling. Next slide. As explained, the installation equipment is an integral part of the whole Avseal system. We provide a wide range of tools, all with special nose equipment designed specifically to suit each Avseal plug. We have the ProSet family of handheld air-powered tools, or there are battery-powered alternatives where extra mobility is a real benefit. The larger plugs are placed with the AV series of hydraulic tools. These are the pistol-type tools linked by an umbilical connection to an electrically driven pump unit. And finally, there are the Viking fully automated placing systems designed for integration into production lines and robotic production cells. In the automotive sector, roughly half of all our Avseal plugs are being installed using this Viking equipment. Next slide. Thank you. So to wrap up this section, I'd just like to run through the Avseal advantages. The first is easy hole preparation, where we just need a simple drilled hole and nothing more. Secondly, Avseal offers reliable compression sealing, where the placing force is controlled by the plug itself, so there are no tool settings required. It is also worth noting here that every single batch of plugs that we manufacture undergoes leak testing in-house before dispatch, and that's as part of our standard quality checks. Third, our unique plug design can accommodate large variations in hole sizes. Fourthly, the actual placing speed is really quick, normally achieved within 1 second, typically as seen in this animation. That's the type of time. The fifth point is that the placing tools are easy to use and operators don't require any special training or skill. And lastly, our hand tools are light and ergonomic. Plus, we have well-proven equipment to enable fully automated placing of Avseal plugs. So now I will hand over to Torsten, who will talk about applications and our technical support.
Yeah, many thanks, John. So we've just heard how simple yet reliable and robust Avseal works, and we've heard the resulting benefits. Trusted by many loyal customers around the world who appreciate the quality, safety, and reliability of our Avseal, many millions of these plugs are manufactured in our factories every year and since many years. Here we see some typical areas of application. Classic combustion engines, transmissions, modern hybrid transmissions and e-machines. However, actuators, pumps and hydraulic components are also among the applications and references. Next slide, please. Yeah, working with you to offer tailored solutions. This is really the main intention in every project. Ideally, we are involved as a partner right from the start, so that we know and understand the application and its specific requirements. We think about the sealing plug and the serial installation. From application analysis to access simulations and extensive testing, we, as your partner, understand your challenges to offer you the best sealing solution. Our fully equipped laboratory area enables application validation support. We support with CAD file data exchange, FEA simulation, functional tests, prototype and pre-series construction, and tooling service. When the fastener design has been decided, the focus is on the manufacturing process. Our Avseal solutions are manufactured to the highest standard with stringent quality controls. Bespoke Avseal solutions are also offered. We also oversee the processing of the Avseal. From the design and manufacture to the delivery and commissioning of our components, we look after our customers and are also available during the ongoing serial process. In this way, we can help provide the optimum Avseal system. Thank you. And with this, I want to hand over to the Q&A session.
Thank you, John and Torsten, for such a detailed walkthrough of Avseal systems and Avseal advantage. Ladies and gentlemen, let's now move to our Q&A session. And just before we open the floor for questions, I would like to invite Veena So, another subject matter expert of ours, to join us in this segment. Venus is a product management director for Blind Asia. And she's been in the fastening world for almost 20 years. She's very well versed in Stanley product lines and has got many years of hands-on application experience in automotive, industrial, and aerospace industry. With that, let's begin the questions. I would like to ask the first question to Venus. So question is, Venus, if there's any limitation or skill required to ensure consistent placement of Avseal?
Thank you, Damini, and good afternoon to all. Actually, as what John has illustrated in the slides, we do not need skilled workers to install Avseal. You and I can place one using proper STANLEY tools. So the end result will be the same. Thank you. Back to you, Damini.
Thank you, Venus. Our next question is, what is the tolerance of the hole? John, would you like to take this one?
Yes. Yes, the drilled hole tolerance for most Avseal in the low pressure and high pressure range is at least 0.4 millimeters. The larger high pressure plugs, the example I gave in the presentation, the 10 millimeter plug can actually go into a hole of 9.8 to 10.8 millimeters and seal effectively. So I think typically, you know, if you work on a basis of 0.4 millimeters, which I think for most production drilling is more than adequate. When we're talking about the Avseal XT, the tolerance is tighter. That's for use in high pressure hydraulics. And the tolerance there is 0.12 millimeters. But again, that sort of tolerance is quite capable with the normal drilling process.
Got it. Thanks, John. We have next question. What about corrosion on stem breakage wet area and contact corrosion for the plug in die casted steel? John, would you like to?
Yes. Yes. Again, a good question and a question that's often asked. In reality, a lot of the plugs are used in this or in similar types of application. Many millions have been used in internal combustion engines where the material is cast iron, for example. Those engines, the outside of the engine casting is in an environment that gets wet, covered in road salts, those sort of things. The corrosion is not an actual issue in terms of service. We don't see much corrosion of the brake surface. The stem itself is coated with zinc. A small area is exposed, but there is zinc around the brake surface, which offers sacrificial protection. And the proof of the pudding is in the fact that there are millions of car engines driving around, and there is no issue with corrosion of the steel stem in those, and they've been on the roads for, you know, maybe 20 or 25 years, and we're not seeing any issues of corrosion even after a very, very extended time in those sort of applications. So to answer the question, we don't see in practice any particular corrosion in contact with steel or cast iron in particular.
Thank you, John. Another question for Thorsten. Are there recorded applications of Avseal with tubing? For example, to use Avseal to tap a copper tube.
Sorry, can you repeat it?
Are there recorded applications of Avseal with tubing? For example, to use Avseal to tap a copper tube.
Yeah, copper. Sorry, Thorsten, I was just going to say on this one, we have seen Avseal plugs used in tube occasionally. It depends on the thickness of the tube and, you know, and whether the tube is annealed and soft, or it's an unusual request. I think on something like that, you would want to see the application, wouldn't you, Thorsten?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think normally we ask for the CAD files, and then we see the application, the materials, or the hardness of the material, the wall thickness. All these dimensions are important for us. And of course, yeah, if we know that, we can make investigations, and then we can start the project. Yeah.
Okay. Our next question is, how easier is it to disassemble these plugs, and do we need special tooling for removal?
Yes. Again, one of the questions that's often asked. We do offer a system of a drill and tap, which is used to extract the plug and prevent the plug parts from falling into the application. So there is a drilling and a tapping operation that engages on the stem, and then the whole plug is pulled out using an adapter that fits onto a normal riveting tool. So you literally pull the plug out and it doesn't leave any parts in the application. So we do offer these systems. Having said that, it's not often used in practice. I think generally the Avseal process is pretty reliable. What it is, and so extraction once people are up and running and experienced with Avseal, extraction is very infrequently required, but we do offer a system, yes.
Okay. Next question. What is the maximum hardness of workpiece when installing Avseal plug? John?
Yes. There isn't really a maximum. The plugs are used in steel and stainless steel applications, I guess, of hardnesses well over 200-250 Vickers points. It's really the surface finish that's the key there. If we're within the limits, which basically means a surface which is not too smooth and not too rough, a typical drilled surface, the outer sleeve keys into that surface and engages effectively. The hardness really doesn't impact the way in which the plug works. So it's not digging into the surface, it's gripping on the natural undulations of a drilled surface to provide purchase and resist blowout. So there isn't really a maximum. And again, we could do testing with a customer to explore that topic, and if there was a very hard application, we could do some make coupons and test the blowout pressure practically in advance to build confidence with the sealing solution.
Thank you, John. Our next question is: is there any after service for automation system that we introduce? Thorsten, would you like to take this one?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yes, there is. Most of our customers' projects are realized with an integrator or line builder. Means they buy our components and integrate it in the workflow of the end customer production. Service, repair, and maintenance is very often done by these integrators. In addition to that, we have our own service technician team and global distribution partners.
Thank you, Thorsten. What are the key considerations to ensure no leakage after using Avseal? John, would you like to take this one?
Yes. I think typically the most important thing is that the hole itself doesn't have scratches, axial scratch marks, or sometimes what we call rifling, which is like a long helix, which happens when the drill is slowly spun and withdrawn from the hole. So these sort of scratches or marks can provide an opportunity for fluid to actually leak past the installed sleeve of the plug. But if the holes are a reasonable quality, this won't be an issue. The sleeve material expands quite nicely. Probably the other consideration is actual damage of the plug before it's put in the hole, and sometimes that can be an issue. If for example the number of plugs have been dropped on the floor or crushed in some way, that can impact how well they seal. But typically these sort of issues are very rare. But normally the Avseal plug will accommodate small imperfections in the hole preparation. And the other point, of course, is cleaning, just making sure that the hole is clean and it's not wet or doesn't have oil on the surface. So those will be the key sort of things to look out for to ensure that the plug then seals reliably.
Thank you. How does Avseal perform against competitor product plugs? Venus, I see you've already answered. Would you like to give it a shot again?
Sorry, come again, your questions?
How does Avseal perform against competitor product plugs?
I think with my years of experience using Avseal against what was in the markets, right? So far, we had excellent feedback from customers that is easy to use, easy to adopt, and is a very, how to say, your preparation job of doing using an FC versus other solutions, like maybe some of the solutions you need to drill the hole, put a thread plug on it, and so on. those has limited in terms of setup times compared to using FC, where we all have seen that we just need to place within a minute, you and I can place it easily. So the kind of cost impact and the ease of use are really stand out to this product line, right?
Thank you, Venus. One more question. What is the permissible runout limit for a hole where Avseal is to be replaced or is to be placed? Sorry.
Oh, okay. I can pick this one up again. It's when we talk about runout, I mean, typically what I would understand that as being would be out of roundness. So basically the hole is slightly trilobular or it's oval to a certain extent through the drilling operation or issues with the drilling operation. Typically we would quote a figure of 0.15 millimeters, which is, well, 0.006 of an inch in old money. So a small amount of out of roundness we can accommodate for sure. So I think it'd be unusual for a hole to be much less round than that. But Avseal typically, because it's got a soft and flexible or ductile sleeve, it is very good at accommodating imperfections in the drilled hole or those sort of effects where you have a slightly oval or out of round hole. So I would give that figure as a typical objective. I think if the out of roundness was much worse than 0.15, then a key thing we'd have to be looking out for would be poor surface finish as well. And that poor surface finish might give rise to leakage rather than the out of roundness. But 0.15 millimeters is a figure to work with for sure.
Thank you, John. Next question is, are there any chances of leakage between sleeve and stem of an Avseal?
Again, I think in the presentation, we were looking at, or one of the things explained was that we have high radial pressure that's acting out onto the wall of the hole, but correspondingly there's radial pressure that squeezes inwards onto the shank of the stem. And you saw there was like a locking groove feature on the stem, but the material is actually forced radial inwards with a great deal of force, and that really cuts off much of the opportunity for leakage. Plus we have that underhead ring, that annular ring. And that is, again, that's a key feature, and it's the special feature of Avseal that really ensures that the fluid can't squeeze in between the stem and the sleeve. So it's the combination of those two areas that really means that there isn't a chance for material to or for fluid to squeeze through that interface between the stem and the sleeve.
Thank you, John. With that, we arrive at our last question. So the question is, previously there was a requirement that the hole should have a certain roughness. Does that still apply?
Yes, I mean, we would want to, I think on one of the slides again, that I think we'll be circulating the presentation, or that there will be linked to the presentation later on if people want to see it again. But the roughness limits, I think in terms of the RZ value, between 5 and 25 microns. That's ranging from a fairly smooth hole to a relatively rough hole. They'll all be sealed effectively. I think it's probably worth bearing in mind that if the hole is much smoother than that, then you're going to start to see a reduction in the blowout performance. And that's why we would typically go for those limits. So I think, you know, within those ranges, within those limits, the roughness is acceptable.
Thank you, John. Well, this was our last question for the session. Here are the contact details of our team members. In case you have any further questions, please do reach out to the mentioned email IDs. If you're from Asia, you could reach out to Venus. If you're from North America, please reach out to Sameer. And if you're from European region, please reach out to Teresa. And with that, it's a wrap on this webinar.